My name is Mike, and this is What's in My Bag. First, I'm going to show you my putting putters. I carry a pair of soft electron ions, and I've been putting with ions for over half a decade now, and I'm just very familiar with them. I like the soft ones because my putting grip is unusual, and that I pinch between the flight plate with my thumb and my middle finger like that. So the soft flight plate gives me a good feel. I think the ion has just a really good combination of glide and predictability, and it works really good for my spin putting style. Next, I'm going to show you my driving and approach putters. First, I've got a pair of soft proxies. The proxy is my favorite disc in my bag, and I throw it for a lot of short drives and approaches, both forehand and backhand. This baby blue one here has been in my bag for a while now. It's a little bit seasoned, and it's got some high-speed turn to it. And this darker blue one with the green rim, this one's fresher, and it has no high-speed turn yet. I love the proxy for all sorts of shots. I'll use it for forehand and backhand. I'll use it for forehand rollers and backhand rollers. And I throw it anywhere from 100 feet to 350 feet, and I love it. It's, like I said, it's the favorite disc in my bag, and it's become a cornerstone very quickly. Next, I've got a pair of soft Envies. And this black and white Oreo Envy, this is one that I've been throwing since MVP sent me the testers way back in the day. I think it was 2014 when I got this one. So it's definitely developed a later fade than a fresh one, and it complements this solid red soft Envy very well. This one's a lot newer, and it has an earlier fade, and it has stronger lateral movement. And this combo is nice for when I need to throw a windier approach, or I want to throw a long-range hyzer approach, and I just don't want any risk of it turning over. It's a little bit more forgiving than the proxy if my form's not totally there. Now I'm going to show you my two mid-range molds. One of the reasons I'm able to get away with such few mid-ranges is I've been throwing this Eclipse Axis for a very long time now. This one's developed some high-speed turn, and it fulfills my understable mid-range slot. This other Axis I've been throwing for a while as well, but not nearly as long. This one's developed a little bit of high-speed turn, but it's still pretty much dead straight if I give it a little bit of hyzer. I also carry a pair of Vectors, and it's kind of the same concept with the Axis. I've got this orange one that's been used for a while. I actually traded for this one, and it was already broken in when I got it, and I've put even more wear on it. And I have this darker red one that's a lot fresher, and kind of like the Envies, it fades earlier and has more lateral movement, and this one will hold a straight line for a longer time. One of the reasons I like pairing these two molds together is if you look at the wings of each of these discs, you can see they're incredibly similar. The Vector has a larger bead on the bottom, and other than that, they've pretty much got the same wing shape. Now we're going to take a look at my fairway drivers. First, I carry a couple Craves. I've got this blue and white one that's been in my bag for years, and I love this disc. This is one of my favorite ones to throw. It's developed a pretty good amount of high-speed turn, but it's still incredibly controllable. If I throw it with some hyzer, it'll flip up to flat, and if I throw it with a lot of hyzer, it'll hold that all the way to the ground. I really like this one for flicks that are just outside of my mid-range distance, where I don't want a whole lot of fade compared to, say, my Fireball or my faster, more overstable distance drivers. It's just a really good disc for those slightly powered down shots that I throw about 75-80% power. I give it a little bit of hyzer, it goes dead straight, and then late in the flight, it has a little fade. It's just an incredibly controllable disc, and this has been a cornerstone in my bag for years. I complement that broken and Crave with this fresher one. This one I can throw flat and hard, and it'll pretty much just go dead straight and have a late fade at the end. It almost flies like a slower broken end volt. This one's just a really useful control driver for me. It gets me a pretty good amount of distance compared to the Vector, but it doesn't have nearly the fade or the skip as the faster disc. So this is a pretty important disc in my bag. Now in addition to the Craves, I've got three other molds that I carry that I also consider fairway or control drivers. These are just slightly faster than the Volt. They don't have a very wide rim. First one is the Axiom Insanity. This one has a significant amount of high-speed turn for me, but I still find it controllable. This isn't a disc that really turns and burns for me. It's one that I can trust to throw hard and high on a backhand line. It'll hold a nice turnover and then pan out at the end. I usually don't flick this one. It's one that I pretty much exclusively throw a backhand. And sometimes I'll throw rollers with it as well, but I usually throw a straighter, more stable disc for rollers because I find those more predictable. They have less left to right movement. So this is pretty much just for backhand turnovers for me. Next, I've got this Wrath. I've been throwing this Wrath ever since I got the original testers from Axiom. And this one's nice and broken in, but it still doesn't really show much high speed turn. If I throw it maximum power, flat, and backhand, it'll show a little bit of high speed wiggle, but it doesn't really want to flip. This is my go-to forehand driver. I just love the way that it flies for my forehand shots. It's got the perfect combination of high-speed stability to resist turning over with a light but predictable fade. It gets me really good distance and shapes really good lines. I use this backhand and forehand, and the Wrath is, in my opinion, like a faster, more aggressive Volt. But like I said, it's not a whole lot faster. You can see the rim is still very narrow for a disc that's labeled a distance driver. In my opinion, this is kind of right on the edge of distance or control. I mean, depending on how you define a disc, it could go either way. And I just really like the Wrath. One thing I like about this and the Insanity and the Fireball, the plastic is nice and soft. And as you saw with my putters, I'm a fan of soft plastics. I feel like they give a little bit better grip and just a better sense of touch. When I squeeze down on the flight plate and can sort of feel that pinch in between my thumb and my finger, I like that. It just feels good to me. And my last control driver is this special edition Fireball. I've been throwing this one for a while, and it actually replaced resistors in my bag this year. The resistor was a cornerstone in my bag for many years. I had been throwing them nonstop since I got the original testers. But the more I used the Fireball, the more I realized that it could cover the same shots as the resistor, and it powers down surprisingly well. I really like the Fireball, and it's become one of the most important discs in my bag. It's just super predictable for hyzers, backhand and forehand, and sometimes I even carry two of them. And lastly, we're going to take a look at the distance drivers in my bag. First, I've got this Axiom Tenacity. This is the newest member of my bag, and I've been pretty impressed with it so far. It's got a significant amount of high-speed turn for me, even more than the Insanity, so it's one that I usually don't throw at 100% power. I like to power this down a little bit and just let it glide out and do its thing. And I really like this for long, controlled turnovers, and I also sometimes throw this for backhand rollers, but like I mentioned, I usually go with something a little bit more stable for predictability. This just has a ton of glide, and that's really impressed me with its easy distance. I've never had a disc that I can throw 500 feet as easily as the Tenacity. I can throw this one about 60-70% power, it feels like, and it just booms. It's pretty crazy to me. It's a disc that I think a lot of players could benefit by trying out, because I think that it would be something that players of different skill levels could really utilize, whether you throw 300 feet or 500 feet. I think the Tenacity could find a place in your bag. Next up, I've got a pair of the Mayhems from Axiom. And if you notice on the Tenacity, I put a couple little lines on it just so I could sort of tell them apart more easily, because these are unstamped prototype ones that I got sent to me before they were actually released to the public. So there's not really any difference between these two yet. I just carry two of them because they're my go-to distance driver. I absolutely love the Mayhem. I fell in love with it the very first day that I threw it. It's incredibly accurate. It's got the perfect combination of glide and predictability for me. When I throw it hard and flat, it'll show a decent little bit of high-speed turn, and then it'll come back with a strong fade at the end. If I give it some hyzer, it'll just go dead straight and then fade out nicely for me at the end. This is my maximum distance forehand and backhand driver. I love it. There's not a bad thing that I can say about it. And the Mayhem is just fantastic. If you go watch the Rolling Pines video that I posted, I got some easy birdies on that course thanks to this disc. I'm number 4, Rolling Pines. Go watch that shot. It is impressive. And lastly, my fast, overstable distance driver. That's the MVP Nitro. The Nitro is a little bit more aggressive and overstable than I originally expected. I was actually surprised. The first few times that I threw it, it really didn't go as far as I expected because it wanted to fight out of the air so hard. So I usually go with the Mayhem for most of my distance shots, and this is reserved more for specialty lines. Say I've got a really strong headwind coming into my face, and I really need to throw a hyzer line that doesn't flip over at all, or I just need that really predictable long-range shot. So the Nitro isn't one that I use for general purpose shots as much as the Mayhem, but it's still a very important disc for me to have, because when you throw 550, 600 feet and you're playing a long course that has wind coming in your face, you definitely need something like this in the bag. So for just long, predictable shots, the nitro is my go-to. Now, I usually don't throw this one forehand because my forehand distance isn't equal to my backhand distance. So I like the Mayhem. It offers a little bit more glide and still has a nice predictable flight for my forehand. But this is essential for my backhand game. And of course, my bag would never be complete without one of these. Now, one other thing I'd like to mention is a lot of times when I play short courses, I take out all these discs. I've got the Tenacity, both my Mayhems, my Nitro, my Wrath, and my Insanity. I don't really need these for a short course. A lot of the courses where I live, they don't really have any holes longer than 350, 400 feet. And if I really wanted to, I could reach those with a putter. So the Fireball and the Crave, those cover my driving bases, and then I work my mids and my putters off the tee aside from that. So it's very rare that I have all the discs in my bag that I just showed you, because a lot of the courses just don't demand that. Well, now that I've shown you what's in my bag, I'm going to show you how they fly. I'm going to pull some footage from the recent videos that I've been filming, and I'm going to let you see how I use every disc that I just showed you and what type of flight I get out of them.
You're only gonna do it if you try.
Oh shit.
Get the fuck out of here, dude!
Fuck you, mother.
Oh, you.
Oh, damn.